In this lecture, we're going to talk about the spinal nerves. So this, a functional unit of the spinal cord is a spinal segment. And a spinal segment is that piece of the spinal cord to and from which all of the rootlets of one single spinal nerve are attached. So if you draw a line here, it's all of these. So it's this. Here's the spinal nerve. Oh, here's the label here, obviously. In the spinal nerve, you have a dorsal root and a ventral root, and it's all of that real estate within the spinal cord that is contributing motor fibers and receiving sensory fibers. Okay, so that is one spinal unit, or one spinal segment, which is the functional unit of the spinal cord. And of course, the modalities are important. So when we think of a spinal segment, we think of one spinal nerve, and then of course all of its dorsal and ventral rootlets, roots, and then the spinal nerve. So you know that the dorsal part of the spinal cord gray is sensory, and that the ventral is motor. And so it goes without saying then, or maybe with, that the dorsal rootlets and root are sensory, the ventral rootlets and root are motor, but they come together here at the spinal nerve. So the spinal nerve is mixed. Okay, so sensory, motor, and then mixed. One more thing about the spinal nerves. They split almost immediately after becoming nerves. So they extend just a little bit, and then we have what is called a dorsal primary ramus. And it's dorsal because it's going towards your back. And ramus means arm. So this is the part of the nerve that goes around and innervates your back so that you can move your back muscles and so that you can feel the sun shining on it in the summertime. The ventral primary ramus is going to curve around the front and innervate your sides and the anterior or ventral part of your body, okay? These are mixed, right? Because they are branches of that mixed spinal nerve. So sensory, motor, mixed, mixed, and mixed. The different components of the spinal nerve reflect the different components of the spinal cord gray matter. So remember that somatic is voluntary, visceral is autonomic. So we have two zones in our dorsal horn. We have our somatic and our visceral, and we have two components in our ventral horn, somatic and visceral. So all four groups of these neurons are going to be represented in any given spinal nerve. So two motor components, two sensory components come together for four different modalities within every spinal nerve, okay? So just to review, somatic afferent, visceral efferent, and somatic efferent, these neurons projecting out, and the neurons from the periphery projecting in, representing the afferent. And in the next segment, we'll talk more about the nerves and how they distribute throughout the rest of the body.